Hi guys, it's Jax here again, and I'm just doing a kind of a follow-up to the first video I just uploaded, and that was the making a knife out of a saw blade. I have a little bit of a follow-up to it. I'm just in the garage here with Pix. For those of you that never met Abby before, she's my puppy. Come on, sit down for a sec, Pix. Yeah, okay, lie down. There you go, champ. Good stuff. So anyways, I better hurry up before my camera memory runs out. So anyways, so in the first video, I have to correct. I said you could cut these type of saw or circular saw blades with hacksaws and chisels. What I meant is files, because in case some of you are wondering. So I had to correct that. Anyways, this is going to be a super quick video. I'm probably going to run out of time. So anyways, the second part here is talking about this type of saw blade for making knives out of. Super thin hand saw blades like this. If you have a used one, a rusty one, saw that someone doesn't mind giving you for free because it's old and it's seen its day, you can make a knife out of that. Here's some examples of that. As you can see with saw blades or files or anything like that, you can leave a bit of the texture from the saw or file on the knife to give it some character. So here's a great big blade made out of one of these. Super thin, which makes an excellent slicer. You can temper it to a spring temper or a really hard temper. This is done at about 400 degrees or a little bit higher. So it's probably up there in the 60s in the Rockwell scale. Another thing I gotta add is when I quenched the piece of circular saw from part one of the saw making blades out of saws, I said it will be really hard, like 60. I meant like 65 on the Rockwell scale, 66, somewhere around there. So I just kinda noticed I screwed up. So these three are all knives. Here we got a Wharncliffe with hickory handles and aluminum rods for rivets peened on. Super thin, super sharp, partial tang. Here we have a full tang with natural hickory handles and brazing rods cut and used for a peen. These are all carbon steels and they'll all rust or patina. This one I left in a silvery finish because when I'm cutting garlic and vegetables, it'll get its own patina. So you just want to make sure you oil them or wipe them off when you're done using them. So really aggressive slicers due to that thinness. Still very strong and very tough material. You don't have to worry about that thinness. This has a neat little patina, triangle shape in the middle. It just turned out that way, and silver around the edges. And this big boy. Hickory handles, full tang design, lanyard hole, aluminum pins, and tempered at about 400, so it's it still has some flexibility due to the thinness, but it's still super hard and it will keep an edge. These are probably good steels. You can do the hardenability test from the first video. And for those of you that didn't understand, these blades will warp, so warp when you heat treat them because they're so thin, unless you get lucky. So what you want to do is you want to take two, like I said in the first one, you want to find a piece of steel, two pieces of steel that are super straight, and you want to put your blade blank in between them and sandwich there, tighten the living heck out of it and clamp it down, and then throw this whole unit into your heat treating oven and get the whole thing hot, and then quench it in a big bucket of water. It has to be a big bucket of water, and it has to be relatively cool water. Don't worry about cracking. Hopefully it won't crack on you, the blade that is. But it needs a fast quench, and even if it's an oil cooled. So anyways, these are probably from the 10X series, and they're all water cooled steels, and some people oil cool them, but I'm not sure oil will be a quick enough quench given that you're using this plate quench design because of the warpage issues. So, and later when you do use these two bars of steel for sandwiching blades to quench in, they'll warp in time. And you can straighten them out every time by throwing them back into the fire later, getting them red hot, and throwing these two plates in between straight pieces of steel like this, and sticking them in a vise while they're red hot, and then squish them together and let them cool that way. And as you can see, anything that gets caught and squished in there, in the vise over there, it'll straighten these pieces of steel up so you can reuse them. So that's what the plate quenching setup looks like for these types of blades. Anyways, this is gonna take, all my videos will take like hours and hours to upload, so just a couple more saw blade things, and just know this is decent steel. And a lot of times it'll be really neat steel, like some of it might be from Sheffield or whatever, and some of it might be really neat stuff like L6 or that. You can force patinas on with vinegar and lemon, or let a natural patina develop by just by cooking and using them in your kitchen. Or you can leave them silvery in silvery color. pardon me, and just oil them and make sure they're dry when you put them away. Any kind of rust forms, you can steel wool it or sand it back down, and put a nice razor sharp edge on them, and you're good to go. So once again, that's Jacks and the Picks here. So anyways, that's the saw blade information, and any comments or if I made any mistakes in the video, let me know, and hopefully I can correct them, because I made a few. Anyways guys, thanks for watching, and hopefully you can make a good blade out of a saw sometime. Bye.